So here we were, miles up the Tietê River, looking for what we did not know.
Max. You listening? Max! So like I was saying, I think they're a group called the Crachá Preto.
Why'd you tell me they were called the CS?
They are. I mean, Fabiana. She was kidnapped by the CS. The guys that crashed our little party at the stadium, they were a group of paramilitaries.
You'll have to forgive me for not being able to follow all this.
You're not supposed to follow it. The government can't even follow it. It ensures that no one's ever guilty.
So why'd they do it? Bust us at the stadium.
Somebody told them we were gonna be there with a whole lot of money. Anyway, the money's gone. Just hope we can get the girl back.
Yeah, me too. Wonder where the hell she is.
You know there's a harbor about a half a mile up? She's gotta be there. This is a known Comando Sombra area.
You know, if I've been doing my job properly, we wouldn't be out here in the middle of nowhere looking for some broad who got pinched on my watch.
That's what we tell ourselves, huh? It's all our fault.
I'm serious. By the time they grabbed the girls, I was half cut. I ain't slipping, man. I'm slipped. I'm a bad joke.
Max, we work private security. We're all ex-soldiers, ex-special forces, ex-cops, ex-good guys. We all have our reasons why we became ex. Maybe now we can put things right, okay?
So that was it, was it? Say the magic word and be absolved of your sins. If only shit were that simple, I'd have done it years ago. Me, I'd been stuck in the past so long, I'd forgotten what year it was.
Max, quit your daydreaming. This is it. It's over there. I'm gonna cut the engine. Light in.
Don't go anywhere.
Here I was, some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. A bullet will sometimes work as well as a key. Idea what lay ahead, and as much as part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation right here. Thank you.
porque que eu sempre fico a parte de mim, porra.
Já te falei pra tu parar de reclamar e fazer teu trabalho, mano.
I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns. I'd seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Vai se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein!
Vá se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
Think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all. I had to press on. I didn't want to find her just in time to watch them deliver the coup de grace. That was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise. I could hear drilling through the wall. It sounded more like boat hull than bone, but I needed to be sure. There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play. But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did. I was in a cocaine factory, but I'd stick to the depressants. I opened the door to the next circle of this low-rent hell. Thank you. These were the floor plans to the nightclub. Seemed Mr. Serrano liked to be prepared. Proper little Boy Scout. I could get through on the catwalk if I went back into the other room. I hadn't seen Fabiana in a worrying amount of time, but at least I wasn't following the trail of her fingers. I had to keep on going across the docks. I prefer to mix these with alcohol, but on this special occasion, I'd make an exception. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. And maybe a few years before that as well. Thank you.
Max? Max? You all right? What's going on? Where's Fabiana?
They took her in a boat. That way. Straight ahead.
Okay, don't worry. Hang on.
Boy, did I need to hang on. The whole operation was slipping out of our grip. I was an overconfident jumper going into the jungle alone.
Shit, more company!
How's she look, man? My gun!
Beat up, broken, alive. I don't know what to say.
Boat's gonna sink, dude!
Sure they missed us.
I got an idea. Hold on.
Fabiana had slipped through my fingers for a second time. Another habit I didn't want or need.
It was close. We almost had her. Damn!
I don't think we ever had much of a chance. No one told us they had an entire goddamn army.
I don't think anybody knew. Crazy shit.
Yeah. It's all crazy, pal. Non-stop insanity. Thought I left all this shit behind. Easy gig, you said. What a fool I was to get involved in this madness.